kid Robotripping, Dextromethorphan, DXM. Not to be mistaken with promethazine, which is that codeine, the purple sister. That's a whole other video. We'll talk about that another time. But these days, and many days before, a lot of kids will get their hands on something called DXM. It's actually within Robitussin, Dayquil. It comes in the gel form. It comes in syrup form, and it's over the counter. It's easily accessible. It can be in your medicine cabinet at home right now. And a lot of kids, you know, obviously they like to experiment with different things. And the reason why they turn to this is because it's there and it's easy and it puts them into a different state of mind. So what does it do? What actually is it? So it's a cough suppressing ingredient actually just made for people who are sick and have a cough. It's also a dissociative anesthetic, which meaning it'll make you hallucinate if you take too much of it. It has the same kind of components that, let's say for example, PCP would have. And it has the kind of the same feel of like mushrooms. So a lot of kids will try to get it to get that out of body experience. They feel differently. They feel like mushy. They actually go into a different state of mind. So it's ingested. It's euphoric once you ingest enough inside of you. And I'm not gonna sit you here and give you all the breakdowns of what amount to take. I don't wanna give anybody any ideas, but we have to be real. The reason that we're talking about this today is because a lot of people, especially kids that are going to rehab, if they have any freedom at any time, they suddenly go into certain stores and they get a bunch of it and they start using it. I remember when I was a kid, I was probably about 16, 17 years old. We were going to high school. We were looking for anything that could get us loaded. If we got our hands on alcohol, that was fine. But sometimes we didn't want to be too sauced. So we would take DXM thinking like it's not really going to mess us up that bad, but it truly did. So once I got it in me, I remember just sitting in my classroom and I was like yellow, just sort of sitting there and checked out. And my brain was going in all different directions. I remember that I had tried mushrooms during that time. So it was a very similar high to that where I kind of felt like, I had all the answers to the world. And then as I kept going, I needed to get out of the classroom and go. And I remember just getting more and more and wanting to do more and more so that I could keep on getting that effect. It definitely, at times I would do so much until I was, I'd get so tired that I'd have to just go home and I wouldn't be able to do anything productive in the course of a day at school. The effects of it lasted anywhere from, an hour or two, but it felt like it lasted a lot longer. Everything was more colorful. I remember that the sound of things sounded much better. The music sounded much better. It just took me into a whole different state of being and mind. So it's not physically addictive, like your body doesn't really need it, but I do remember that mentally it was addictive and I just kept on wanting to get more and more if I could get it and I couldn't get anything else. So if I couldn't get it from my parents' medicine cabinet, I would definitely somehow get into the store, buy it, use it. And amongst our friends, this was something that we experimented with quite often. I haven't seen people actually seek treatment for DXM use, although I have seen people in the treatment setting seek DXM because they know that it's an instantaneous high and they sometimes can fly under the radar, although sometimes when they are getting tested it does show up in their system. Just more recently somebody admitted that they had taken some Nyquil and they knew that there was certain components in it that could get them more high, and they, even though they denied that they were seeking that, they took high doses for that very purpose. I think any drug can be a gateway drug. I mean, I have my own opinions, but I know that people would use DXM as just some, usually like in an experimental way, but I know that it's also been used in the dance, electronic dance festivals. People will use it to mix it with other drugs. It is highly dangerous when mixed with other drugs. It's highly dangerous when mixed with alcohol. It can be life-threatening. So I never used it in tablet form, but I do remember when we used to drink it, we would drink it really fast so that we would get the quick effect of it, because if you take your time with it, you may not get the common effect that it was supposed to intend, that's intended to make you actually get messed up. Other psychological effects of DXM are anxiety, visual and auditory hallucinations, euphoria, slurred speech, panic attacks, disorientation, floating, feeling, altered perception of time. If you'd like to learn more about DXM, click here.